Good morning, comrades. Welcome back to the channel. Welcome back at the Nürburgring. Welcome back at Apex. We've been shooting a video series called The Summit for like already like for a pretty long time with the Summit.
A couple of years.
So, and you probably can tell by the setup, you've seen already two videos published by now. And there was one question that was asked, what is the most challenging aspect of running business at Apex? And we wanted to include it as just one question, but we kept on talking so long about it that we decided it deserves a video of its own. So the question was, what's the most challenging part about doing business at Apex?
Well, I mean,
I think I can answer it from my part.
You probably have something interesting from a media aspect.
Exactly. So the reason of success, so to say, behind Apex, without a doubt, a big part of success at Apex has to do with social media. The vlogs, just the personal aspect of social media posts, and what leads to customers or people in general come to Apex and not just say like, hey, I want to experience the fastest car ever built by Holy Father and Son and Holy Grail, the GT2 RS MR and etc. Or I just want to drive the GT86 or whatever. But I just want to come and hang out and meet the people here at Apex, whether like Robert and I or Diana or Tom, etc. You name it. And that's awesome. That's freaking amazing. But there is a very thin line between the people who are coming from social media and people who are just simply walk-ins or people who have read a good review on google.com or just had a recommendation from the friend, but they have absolutely no idea that there's like the whole social media behind it. So this last group of people who are just there, we provide them still the best possible service. Doesn't matter if they're the biggest fan from the very beginning of 2017. We still provide everyone equal amount of service, but there is not this like personal interaction that we force ourselves towards it, right? Because we don't know it. So it's kind of going to be awkward if someone gets in with like, okay, Diana says to me like, hey, there's a guy in a Cupra, you need to do one instruction lab, jump in with him. Okay, I'm going to go with him and say like, okay, how are you doing? This and that. These are the rules. This is how we're going to do it. Let's go have fun. And I'm just doing my job as an instructor. But then a few days later, we see a review or like a comment on Facebook. Yeah, it was actually not that cool. Yeah, the car was great and the service was great, but there was just nothing exceptional because Misha was kind of quiet and didn't make a talk with me. But for me, I don't know if the person is like introvert, if he wants to talk, if he's there again.
Or if he even knows who we are.
Exactly.
We have people that find us because of a Google review.
That's what I said, yeah.
And they just jump in and say, okay, I'm going to go take a lap. And they don't really, I don't want to say they don't care who Apex is.
Yeah.
They just don't know. And they're there to learn the track.
I just put myself then in the mindset of whenever I order an Uber or a taxi, and then the taxi driver starts talking about his like lifetime story. And I'm like, dude, I just want to get to the destination. And I'm like, you know, I'm typing or calling, like, you know, be quiet. I respect you as a human being, but I'm not asking for a conversation unless I reach out myself. And it's great that the Uber has now an option where you can say like, please be quiet.
Don't talk to me.
Yeah.
So I think what Misha's saying is from my take on it, mm-hmm. is this is the first time I'm hearing this. And the way I take it is that really the best tip I could give you guys is we're here doing this. We're sitting here drinking whiskey with you guys. Yeah. You know, maybe you're watching this at 8 a.m. I'm sorry that you can't do this. Maybe a little later you can have a drink, but we're doing this because we're interacting with you guys. Mm-hmm. These are all questions that you've asked, and we're telling you our honest feelings about AMGs. We're telling you what we think of Formula One drivers, about McLarens and the problems that they have from the last video and all these different things. But you're getting to know us. You're getting to know me. Misha, you guys through COVID saw a lot of my kids and you're getting to know them and seeing how they're growing and things like that. But we only know you from the comments. Mm-hmm. We don't actually get to see your face. And a lot of you, we actually don't even know your real name.
Yeah.
Because we see you as whatever your handle is. You know, Misha's Misha, I'm Robert, that's our handles. And so if I come and say, hi, I'm Robert Mitchell, you might recognize it if I commented on your channel enough, and you might not. The one thing that I would say to help that is when you come in, introduce yourself. Mm-hmm. Introduce yourself as somebody that follows us on Facebook, Instagram, or YouTube, or for me, OnlyFans, right? Mm-hmm. If you're on my OnlyFans account.
Yeah.
You know, tell me that that's where you're from. And in that case, we'll actually be able to say, oh, okay, so did you see this video? We'll be able to talk to you about some of these things, but we can't possibly know where you're from and who you are. You know, and don't be shy to, because just like I mentioned earlier, It's just people.
Exactly.
You know, it's just come up and talk to us. We're here because we love the Nürburgring cars, and definitely
let us know, like, hey, if you want to talk cars, sure, we will talk cars, especially in down season, off time. We happily, like, on the way to the track, I'm happy to hear all about your shitbox in comparison to my shitbox. Like,
who has a bigger shitbox?
Exactly. we love to talk cars, but just, like, let us know that you are here and, like, you do want to engage in this conversation, and because then I'm more than happy to talk about things and all the lap times and whatever, whatnot, and all the lap records, all the cool stuff. So let us know. So this is, like, the kind of, like, the tricky bit. And on the other hand, another thing is also related to the social media aspect, is that now that we have grown with this, like, the social media presence, especially my channel with, like, now over 230,000 subscribers and almost
channel.
50, exactly. Yeah, huge, big. you'll get to that at some point as well. Is that we really need to watch out of what we're saying, because a very recent example is that Lewis was changing the wheels, or George was teaching him how to change wheels. And I said, like, oh yeah, he is a Mexican, he knows how to change wheels, or, like, how to steal wheels. And there were some people, like, some people said, like, hey, I'm a Mexican and I find it funny, it's cool. And some people, I'm not a Mexican, but I find it a racist, and you're a freaking racist, I'm gonna unsubscribe now. I'm like, hold on a second. If you would walk in here without, as a customer, you would see some dirty things that we're talking to each other. That's how we interact here at Apex. You know, like, oh, you're British, like, oh, you George, you're stabbing people with a knife, everyone. Oh, me, drunk Russian, and whatever, whatnot, like, American loving pancakes.
And I think that is a challenge, because we want to share a lot about what Apex does, and the team has a lot of fun together.
Exactly.
You know, the team has a lot of fun together, and there's a lot of jokes like that. And yeah, I mean, the example you give of Luis, you know, being Mexican and you know, I mean, Luis, he's the kind of guy that will do anything.
He's the guy who went to your music studio and recorded
happy birthday in Spanish,
in,
you know,
Spanish, just to take fun of himself. So
Purple Production juice. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
Oh no.
Happy birthday. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. Happy birthday to you.
So he's the type of guy that will do anything. And if it's time to cut the grass, he's like, I'm cutting the grass, you know. And then so the joke at Apex is, oh, you know, Robert, you know, the first American person to have a Mexican gardener, the only American to have a Mexican gardener in Europe, you know.
Yeah.
And Luis laughs because he knows there's so many stereotypes in this world that people use in a negative way.
Yeah.
You know, and that's not Luis. Luis is just a fun guy that he'll make the same jokes about, like you said, you or himself or about me or anybody. And I think it's important to understand that when we share stuff with you guys, there's nobody here that has a negative attitude towards anybody else here.
Exactly. And the reason why I'm bringing this up is because that person who said to me, like, hey, I'm subscribing for your channel, you're a racist. I'm like, okay, if you cannot take a joke, sure, I'm not holding a grudge. But then he went onto Shmi's channel and saying, like, why are you collabing with this racist? Dude, come on.
Yeah.
Like, that was just like, that's what I'm bringing this up.
It is a challenge, you know, when you're open and you're an open company. I mean, even there's little things like, I'll segue into what my biggest challenge is, but there's little things like around the Nürburgring, you know, we share with you guys what cars we want to get. There's a company that I could say that I'm buying I don't know, what's the biggest piece of shit that's out right now? I'm buying a freaking Picasso.
Yeah.
Okay, and I'm going to use it as my next taxi, and they will buy a Picasso next week.
Yeah.
You know, and there's things like that that you just look at it and you're like, okay, this is weird. But so for us, the social media is really positive in the sense that it lets us interact with you guys. It is what Apex is actually built on, how we share our business with you. But at the same time, there are things that we have to watch out what we're doing.
Mm-hmm.
We have to really pay attention to what we're doing. And, you know, it is a challenge for me. It's a big challenge because how many times have we said, okay, we're going to make a video about this. And I'm like, nope, we're not making the video because the Porsche has the wrong wheels on it. Stop, you know, and you always want the correct image to be portrayed. Yeah. You want the car to be put in its best presence. You know what I mean? You want the car to be clean. You want it to look good. Oh, the interior is too dusty, this, that, the other. You want to make sure that your best foot is put forward. You also want to show the excitement that we have, you know? So if we say, okay, Apex is something exciting. We're bringing an excitement to taxi that I don't think has been here for a long time. Mm-hmm. I think before Apex came into the taxi program, it was kind of like, this is just what we do.
Yeah.
This is just what you do. You go for a lap, but that's what you get. And we wanted to make it exciting with cars and more so with the staff. Mm-hmm. When we started, we had a team that I think was, you know, really exciting and really young and fresh and brought a lot to the table. And you guys were really receptive of that. And that was a lot of fun to bring that young, fresh attitude, not just in the cars, but in the staff. And that's what we're continuing now. And whereas that's been great for us in interacting with you guys, it's created this almost excitement around the taxi program that you know from the M5s drifting and you know from the, you know, the old taxis doing all these exciting things. And then I start to think, well, gosh, did we do too much promotion for this? Is it going to basically promote ourselves out of a job? You know what I mean? Yeah. Because other companies that, you know, I still have to look at it and say, okay, I'm okay with the certain loss, but at a certain point I have to say, well, this is too much, you know? So I think it is a challenge, you know, to find that balance between sharing what we do, sharing what we love, sharing the inside jokes, sharing the excitement, and, mm-hmm. and saying, okay, is it too much?
Yeah, it's a very thin line of, again, doing just us here being for fun and trying to share that fun and excitement, and at the same time trying to portray a business, and all of a sudden realizing like, oh, we are actually, well, influencers in that regard. Well,
influencing.
We are influencing.
I'm definitely tier one.
There's you no are tier one, yeah, of course. Don't share any tears.
Don't shed any tears for me, because I only have one.
I have 99 problems, but the tear ain't one.
That's messed up. So I don't know how many of you know about this joke, but I was offered a McLaren from McLaren,
yeah,
and they were going to give me a 600 LT Spider to drive to Italy. I was going to do laps on the Nürburgring with it, and I was going to drive it to Italy because they know that I mostly only drive my cars on the Nürburgring, mm-hmm. and I was going to go have some fun with it and drive it through the Alps, and we were going to video it. We were going to take the T6 bus and, you know, do some really cool stuff. And they called me and said, well, you know, we got to hold off because, you know, we don't want to upset our tier one media.
Yeah, so, some girls who have 5,000 subscribers.
Yeah, some 5K subscribers and some blonde people. Yeah. But the reality was now that's become our joke that you know, make me tier one. You
exactly,
know.
Make Robert tier one media so he can get all the brand deals and all the press invitations.
Shoe deals, glove deals, bike deals.
Yeah. I would love some shoe deals. That would be cool. I'm like, I'm rocking Ultra Boost always from Adidas, so I'm like, it would be nice.
You should tag them.
I should tag them. And
so what is my biggest challenge with running Apex as a business? It is actually running Apex as a business.
Ooh.
Isn't that weird?
Oh, yeah. I can imagine that.
You know,
you're like it's the worst business model that you're sometimes doing the decisions that you like because you're just...
Exactly. I love it. And so I come in and they're like, this guy wants to do it. I'm like, let's go, let's bring him out. I'll take him for a lap, you know?
Yeah.
And so for me, it's a matter of saying, okay, maybe we have 15 employees at Apex and we've got all these cars around and I come to the Nürburgring because I love it and I don't want to just sit here and, okay, this guy needs to pay that, he needs to pay that, you know, and you get people that come.
We gave a very good example for people, like on the last video, or like probably a couple of videos ago by now, of when the guy crashed and he couldn't pay off the excess. Mm-hmm. For many of the new audience, there was like an amazing story, and it is still, and it is a great example.
Right.
Because we were waiting at the end of the day, like... Actually, at some point, I think we even forgot. And then the guy...
he paid us some money.
He paid like because the deal was he would pay like a couple of hundred euros or 100 euros a month. And then we just stopped and we're like, okay, whatever. And then we just like, we weren't keep track. And all of a sudden, like, Diana's like, hold up. Why all of a sudden we have 5,000 euros on our bank account? Like,
yeah. And it is. It's for me, it's a challenge of running it as a business and saying, you have to pay for this mm-hmm. because it's something I want to do. You know, at the end of a taxi lap, there's days that... We charge $299 for the GT2 RSMR, which it's a half a million euro car. Mm-hmm. And we're going out on a lap and charging $299 for it. It costs more than $299 to do a lap. And I still, at the end of it, feel bad taking that $299 from people because I'm like, man, I love doing this. Mm-hmm. You know, and so you, for me, it ends up being this issue of running it as a business. We have a gentleman that came and he took a lap in both cars. And... In the 620 and the GT2, and he goes, man, Robert, you know what? I took a lap in the GT2, and I don't know how the 620 could top it. Mm-hmm. He goes, why don't we just go for a drive on the streets? Mm-hmm. And we'll just talk. Mm-hmm. And I was like, the guy just paid 399 euro to go in this car, and I'm just going to take him on the roads. I took him all over, you know, showed him things. And I just point at a certain point, I said, you know what? Screw this. I just pulled over. I said, you're driving now.
Yeah.
And it's my brand new 620R with 1,000 kilometers. I said, you're driving now. He goes, well, what do you mean? I said, I don't feel right about this, you know. Yeah. I want you, but it's what he asked for and he wanted. And I just said, get in the driver's seat. Let's go, you know. Maybe he drove it like 3 kilometers. But, you know, that's for me more exciting than just showing how good of a driver I am or you know, how great this McLaren is or how great Apex is. I want people to have fun. And so there's been times that, you know, people are out on a lap and there's a whole long line of people waiting to come in, and they say, I want another lap. I'm like, no, screw it, let's go. So I think for me, the hardest thing is really keeping it to a business and realizing that at the end of the day, it needs to make some money. Mm-hmm. And there's multiple reasons why it needs to make some money. And one big one is that the German Finanzamt, which is the German IRS for you Americans, they require that a business makes money.
Yeah.
They can't just write off a loss every year and then be like, you know, this is great, you know. So the company has to be viable to some sense.
Yeah.
And that's hard for me because I really do love sharing the Nürburgring with people. Mm-hmm. I love sharing these cars with people because I don't think there's many places you can go and meet true enthusiasts that say, I'm here to drive this taxi with you because I love it. Mm-hmm. I'm here to spend ridiculous amounts of money on my Cooper, my M4, my M2, so that you guys can experience it and actually enjoy it. When I look at the price list, I'm like, man, will people pay that? Can they pay that? Can they afford that? Mm-hmm. You know, and I look
should
at it.
Should we get a shit box?
Yeah, should we get a shit box? And you know, but why don't we get a shit box? Because I feel it's going to put you guys in jeopardy.
Yeah.
There's companies at the Nürburgring that rent absolute shit.
Yeah.
And I wouldn't want anybody that's on my channel to ride in that car, to drive in that car, because I don't know what's going to happen to it. Mm-hmm. You know, we pay a lot of money for insurances for rental cars. All of our taxis, if you look in the papers, they're actually registered as a taxi, which in this case is actually registered as a chauffeur car. Mm-hmm. So you're hiring the car with a chauffeur legally is what you're doing.
It's basically Uber and Uber.
Yeah, exactly. So go register a 620R or GT2 RS with Manthey-Racing modifications as a taxi and see what that insurance costs. It's ridiculous. And I still sit there and think, oh my gosh, can the customer pay this? Are they going to be, do they feel like they got their money's worth? You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And it is a challenge for me. So I'd say that's my most difficult part. Treating it as a business and not just saying, come on, get in the car, let's go. Mm-hmm. And when we talk about, are we getting a taxi license?
Yeah.
One of the thoughts that I had was, oh man, maybe I talk to the Nürburgring and get an agreement where I have a taxi light license, you know, where I can just take people out, you know what I mean?
We don't advertise it.
Yeah, don't ever, you know, and you know, it's such a challenge and such a balance, because really I'm here to share the Nürburgring with people. Mm-hmm. That's what my goal for Apex is. That's what my desire is. I want the Apex team, everybody that works here, to share that same experience. We spoke earlier about Luis, how he's, you know, he's a freaking character.
Yeah.
But everybody says, man, this guy just showed me just a passion for the Nürburgring. Mm-hmm. You know, his helmet has like 400 Nürburgring stickers on it, you know, and every day he has a Nürburgring jacket. You know what I mean? And you've got like, it's everybody, you know. Ian came here because he just came once and just loved it so much. He just needed to come. Yeah. You know, Misha tried to leave. He tried to go to Rimac and stay there. And he's like, I'm homesick. Take me back. Yeah. You know, it's interesting, you know? And so all these people, and it's like, you know, I talked to Diana and she's like, yeah, I just love people coming and experiencing the cars and seeing what's going on. If anybody from the Apex team has actually made it this far, all of the team is what makes it that way. And it's actually what I expect from every team member. Mm-hmm. You know, Pete, he sits out there and talks to people, you know, hours and tells them about every single car. He's like, well, the torque on this wheel nut is this, the torque on that wheel nut is that. And they're like, oh, that's really cool. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
He's going into detail with them.
And he's not only detailing cars, he's detailing people.
Yeah, he's detailing people. Yeah, he's giving all the details. And it's really cool to see. You know, it's really cool that we have all these people that are so into it. And I feel that for the most part, the team has that same, would you say, dilemma that I have, that it's a job, but it also needs to be.
It's always difficult. It's always difficult. And like it is a fine balance when we like balancing the social media, it's always a fine balance for you, like balancing the business and personal aspect. We had a guy, like, again, also the guy who crashed the car, and like you invited him back for the hotel and stay, and people commenting like, oh, okay, I'm going to crash a car at Apex because then we're going to get a return. We had the guy in 2018 here, homeless from Romania or something. He came on his bicycle. He spent a week camping here.
Yep.
And he's like,
he camped right out here in the yard.
He was camping in our yard. Yeah. And I'm like, dude, what the hell? And like, you cannot just like do it. But it's like, I just want a lap. We're like, okay, let's go.
Yeah, so we put him in the car because we didn't know what he was doing, and he was the coolest guy. He loved it.
Exactly. Those are like the amazing stories, but then at some point you kind of need to make a choice between like, okay, am I taking the money from one person? Why am I not taking from someone else?
And that's something I hope you guys understand. If you're in a position at home that you can afford a lap in one of these cars, you can afford to drive one of your rentals, one of our rentals, and you can afford to do it. I hope you see that when we see that somebody can afford it, and maybe you've saved up every cent you could to do it, and we then give a lap to somebody that can't, hopefully you see that you were actually a part of that as well. The lap that you bought enabled us to say, okay, these costs make it worth it. So we can give this guy that rode his bike here. And we're not talking motorcycle, we're talking bicycle. I'm proud that I rode my bike around the Nürburgring. This guy rode from Romania.
From Romania on a just single speed bicycle.
On a fixie.
With bags, with his camping. He came on a bicycle to the river to get a lap.
And so, you know, you guys are contributing to that as well. When you say, wow, you know, I had to pay, but this guy got it for free. You know, we try and balance everything, you know what I mean? And we try and do it the way that we can. And I can tell you that Apex is paying the most, you know, for this. But each person that takes a lap in this car, each person that buys a voucher.
Is it too hot now?
Hot stuff.
Probably too hot.
Each person that buys a voucher, that's where I was at. So I know that Apex is paying the biggest cost of all of this, but what I can say is for each of you guys is that each time you buy a voucher, you buy a lap, you buy a rental car, you do all this stuff, you're also helping the whole cause of what we're trying to do. And hopefully you're feeling like you're a part of it, that... Mm-hmm. When you pay for what you do, it allows us to also give to those who can't. Mm-hmm. And I think that's maybe you're also helping out my biggest problem or biggest difficulty in running the Apex business by supporting the Apex business so that other people can get involved with it. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I think when you love something, you want to share it with people.
Yeah, absolutely.
And I think that for me, I see it as I'm in a very fortunate position to be able to share certain things with people. And hopefully those of you who can afford to do it can say, hey, I'm also taking this and putting it on my shoulders.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah, so I guess this pretty much sums it up, our very unique problem, like the difficulties that we have with running business.
Social media. The desire not to take people's money.
Exactly. That's probably... I don't know if you people were expecting that as an answer, or like, definitely someone who asked it, and just people in general. But long story short, if you come here and you're watching the vlogs, you're following the social media, you're like really hyping about it, we appreciate it. But let us know, so we can actually have completely different personal approach towards you. So we can talk about the vlogs, talk about the cars and all the stuff. And if you watch the vlogs and you just don't want to, like, don't want us to talk, you're just here for the service, that's fine too.
Yeah.
It's
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, some of you might come and say, look, I watch the vlogs, but I'm cool, you know?
Yeah.
I think to help Misha out, or that perspective, when you walk in the door, tell everybody why you're here.
Yeah.
And everybody will be pumped to hear it. You know, Tom comes and be like, man, this guy's been watching the vlogs since this time. He's been in this car, that car, that car.
Exactly.
They eat it up. They love it. Yeah. You need to share that with us. You know, you need to tell us.
Exactly. And I have also like examples whenever, like when I come to the office and a person is already sitting in the car waiting for me, and Tom is saying like, dude, this is like your biggest fanboy or something, you know, like in a very positive way. He's been watching all the videos and this and that. He's hyped to meet you. So, okay, I get that from him, and I get in the car and I do the general introduction. and then I hear nothing from the person. And I'm like, but you've been telling someone else that you are really so pumped about it. And then, of course, I started going into this interaction and saying like, oh, I heard you, like you've been watching the vlogs and being like...
And so then they start to open up.
They start to open up.
But I think that's something that you guys should realize is that, again, it comes back to this is just, we're all just friends here.
Yeah.
You know, just treat it as we're friends. We're just coming to hang out. With the 620, we bumped it up in price. I said, I want it to be extremely exclusive. But I told the team, I said, I want to know everything about every person that gets in that car. Mm-hmm. If somebody books that car, I want to know why they booked it, who they are. Do they have a McLaren? Do they like McLaren? Do they hate McLaren? Or, you know, why did they book that car? I want to know everything about them because I want to be able to connect with that person and be able to talk to them because I don't want it just to be a lap. Mm-hmm. I want it to be an experience. I want the 620 to be an experience that I share with people in the Nürburgring. I don't care if we're talking about your cat that died or... what your hobbies are or whatever. I want it to be that we're able to share an experience, and that only comes from you guys sharing with us what your story is. And not only does it help us share those stories on the Nürburgring in laps and instruction laps and taxi laps, but also here in the videos, you know, the comments that people have been putting in are awesome. Just every time Misha's camera dies, I mean, if it was my camera, it wouldn't have died yet, as you guys have seen, chop and drop. I don't have these problems. Yeah, because my video is only 10 minutes, right? But each time the camera stopped, we've sat and opened up our phones and seen like 10 other things. We're like, we could talk about that, you know?
And that's why you probably saw like the video that was published first in this setup.
The bottle was out there.
No, we're like empty and talking about these things. But you know what they say? There are two types of people who are honest in the world, kids and, well, tipsy people are woo-woo. So well, we're not, but anyhow, we're talking honest things.
Yeah,
we want to have an open conversation with you guys, and that's where we're answering these questions. So keep these questions coming, and well, keep yourself and your physical presence coming to the Nürburgring. We're very much looking forward to meet you and do laps together, and hope to be able to share this. Well, we'll be able to share the Nürburgring love with you through videos or through cars. Yep. We will see you taxi or not taxi, who cares?
Hopefully taxi.
We'll drink to that. So,
so.
Keep the questions coming. Subscribe to our Instagrams for further Q&As and also just also here on YouTube and everywhere else. Thank you very much for the, again, one more time, amazing questions, and looking forward to answer some more. Until next time.
Easy, guys.
Cheers.
Why do you keep doing that?
I haven't done it since like last 10 videos probably by the time
this. You did it the last video we did together. You did
yeah,
it.
Yeah, but
that was 10 videos ago.
Exactly. That's what I mean.
Bye, guys. All right, cool.
Empty bottle.
Woo! Handled that, huh?
Yeah.
All right. That was